folks dream of the wonders they'll do before their time on this planet is through. Some just don't have anything planned. They hide their hopes and their heads in the sand. Now I don't say who is wrong, who is right, but if by chance you are here for the night, then all I need is an hour or two to tell the tale of a dreamer like you. We all dream a lot. Some are lucky, some are not. But if you think it, want it, dream it, then it's real. You are what you feel. But all that I say can be told another way, in the story of a boy whose dream came true. It could be I closed my eyes, drew back the curtain to see for certain what I thought I knew. Far, far away, someone was weeping, but the world was sleeping. Any dream will do.
I wore my coat
with golden lining, bright colors shining, wonderful and drums, a flash of light, my golden coat flew out of sight. The colors faded into darkness. I was left alone. May I return?
was old.
was quite my favorite wife. I never really loved another all my life. And Joseph was my joy because he reminded me of her.
Through young Joseph, Jacob lived his youth again. Loved him, raised him, gave him all he could. But then it made the rest feel second best. And even if they were, could not imagine any danger. He just saw in Joseph all his dreams come true. Jacob wanted to show the world he loved his son, to make it clear that Joseph was the special one. So Jacob bought his son a coat, a multicolored coat to wear.
Joseph's coat was elegant and cut.
Just a load of corn. rise above us all. The accuracy of the dreams we brothers do not know. But one thing we are sure about, the dreamer.
Souls in paradise. Someone
one less place at our table. There's one more tear in my eye.
Don't tip the things that you stood for.
Like truth and light never die.
Carve his name with pride and courage.
Let no tear be shed.
If he has our name down.
That I could really live in style.
And he did.
Oh, and I did.
Joseph was an unimportant slave who found he liked his master. Consequently worked much harder, even with devotion. Potiphar could see that Joseph was a cut above the average. Made him leader of his household, maximum promotion.
My wife would never toe the line.
It's all there in chapter 39 of Jealousy.
Don't believe everything you read, my dears.
She was beautiful but evil. Saw a lot of men against his will. He would have to tell her that she still was his.
You're mine!
Joseph's looks and handsome figure had attracted her attention. Every morning she would beckon,
come and lie with me, love.
Joseph wanted to resist her till one day she proved too eager. Joseph cried in vain.
Please stop, I don't believe in free love.
Pity.
The world from me. all the windows and shut out the light. Do what you want with me. Hate me and laugh at me. Darken my daytime and torture my night. If my life were important, I would ask, will I live or die? But I know the answers lie far from this world. Close every door to me. Keep those I love from me. Children of Israel are never alone, for I know I shall find my own peace of mind. For I have been promised a land of my own.
Dreams that we don't understand. servants of Pharaoh the king, both in the doghouse were doing their thing.
One was a baker, a cook in his prime. One was a butler, the Jeeves of his time.
Tell me of your dreams, my friends, and I will tell you what they show. Though I cannot guarantee to get it right, I'll have a go.
First the butler, trembling, took the floor. Nervously he spoke of what he saw.
There I was standing in front of a vine. I picked some grapes and I crushed them to wine. I gave them to Pharaoh, who drank from my cup. I tried to interpret, but I had to give up.
You will soon be free, my friend, so do not worry anymore. The king will let you out of here. You'll buttle as you did before.
Next, the baker rose to tell his dream, hoping it would have a similar theme.
There I was standing with baskets of bread. High in the sky I saw birds overhead. Flew to the basket and ate every slice. Give me the message, like his would be nice.
Sad to say, your dream is not the kind of dream I'd like to get. Pharaoh has it in for you. Your execution date is set. Don't rely on all I said I saw. It's just that I have not been wrong before.
You ever find yourself near white on the cards. But if my analysis of the position is right, at the end of the tunnel there's a glimmer of light. For all of the sudden indescribable things have shattered the sleep of both peasants and kings. Strange as it seems, there's been a run of crazy dreams, and the man who can interpret could go far, could become a star.
Hey, hey, hey. Hey, Joseph, won't you tell poor old Pharaoh, what does this crazy, 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 crazy dream mean? Oh, yeah!
7 years of bumper crops are on their way. Years of plenty, endless wheat and tons of hay.
Cool!
Your farms will boom, there won't be room to store the surplus food you grow. After that, the future doesn't look so bright. Egypt's luck will change completely overnight, and famine's hand will stalk the land with food and all time low. Noble king, there is no doubt what your dream is all about. All these things you saw in your pajamas are a long-range forecast for your farmers, and I'm sure it's crossed your mind what it is you have to find. Find a man to lead you through the famine with the flair for economic planning. But who this man could be, I just don't know. Who this man could be, I just don't know.
Joseph is a clever kid. Who'd have thought that 14 cows could mean the things he said they did? Joseph, you must help me further. I have found a job for you. You shall lead us through this crisis. You shall be my number two.
Pharaoh told his guard to fetch a chisel from the local store, whereupon he ordered them to cut the chains that Joseph wore. Joseph got a royal pardon and a host of splendid things: a chariot of gold, a cloak, a medal, and some signet rings. Joseph, Pharaoh's number two. Joseph, Egypt looks dream. Joseph, Pharaoh's number two. Joseph, Egypt looks dream. Joseph. 7 summers on the trot were perfect, just as Joseph said. Joseph saw that food was gathered, ready for the years ahead. 7 years of famine followed, Egypt did not mind a bit. First recorded rationing in history was a hit.
Buddies, that's you and me. I was wise to have chosen you. You'd be wise to agree. What a baffled Abraham. But now that we're a partnership, it's just a piece of cake.
Greatest man since Noah, only goes to show up.
Anyone from anywhere can make it if they get a lucky break.
This could be a happy ending, perfect place to stop the show. Joseph, after all, is not about as far as he can go. But I'm sure that Jacob and his other sons have crossed your mind.
Good years in Canaan.
the summers were endlessly gold.
Mary!
The fields were a patchwork of clover.
All over!
The winters were never too cold. We strolled down the boulevard together, and everything around us was fine.
Now the fields are dead and bare, no joie de vivre anywhere. Et maintenant, we drink a bitter wine.
Those Canaan days we used to know, where have they gone? Where did they go? And yet, raise your berets to those Canaan days.
Do you remember those wonderful parties?
Ooh la la!
The splendor of Canaan's cuisine. Mwah. Those extravagant, elegant soirees. The gayest the Bible has seen. It's funny. But since we lost Joseph, we've gone to the other extreme. No one comes to dinner now. We'd only eat them anyhow. I even find I'm missing Joseph's dreams.
Those Canaan days we used to know. Where have they gone? Where did they go? Have yet raised your berets to those Canaan days.
It's funny, but since we lost Joseph, we've gone to the other
extreme. Perhaps we all misjudged the lad.
Perhaps he wasn't quite that bad.
And how we miss his entertaining
dreams. Those Canaan days we used to know. Where have they gone? Where did
Mighty prince, give us something to eat.
shall now take them off for a ride. After all they have tried fratricide. I dreamed that in the fields one day the corn gave me a sign. Your 11 sheaves of corn all turned and bowed to mine. I dreamed I saw 11 stars, the sun, the moon and sky, bowing down before my star, and now I realize why! How do I know where you come from? You could be spies!
No!
Telling me that you are hungry, that could be lies. How do I know who you are? Why do you think I should help you? Would you help me?
Yes!
Why on earth should I believe you? I've no guarantee.
Crumble, crumble, cringe, bow, stoop, fall. Worship, worship, pain, kneel, smudge, crawl. Crumble, 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 crumble,
I rather like the way you're talking, astute and sincere. Suddenly a tragic story gets me right here.
This is what we hoped he'd say.
All this tugging at my heartstrings seems quite justified. I shall give you what you came for, and lots more besides. And lots more besides. And lots more besides.
Thank you, Worship, worship, Ramamil's crumb.
Joseph handed them sack loads of food, and they groveled with base gratitude.
Then unseen, Joseph nipped out around the back and planted a cup in young Benjamin's sack.
When the brothers were ready to go, Joseph turned to
your little numbers up. One of you has stolen my precious golden cup.
Joseph started searching through his brother's sacks. Everyone was nervous, no one could relax. Is it Reuben?
Yeah.
Is it Simeon?
Yeah.
Is it Naphtali?
Yeah.
Is it Dan?
Yeah.
Is it Asher?
Yeah.
Is it Issachar?
Yeah.
Is it Levi?
Yeah.
Who's the man? Is it Zebulun?
Yeah.
Is it Gad?
Yeah.
Is it Judah?
Benjamin, you nasty youth, your crime has shocked me to the core. Never in my whole career have I encountered this before. God, seize him, lock him in a cell, throw the key into the Nile as well.
Each of the brothers to his knees.
Show him some mercy, Almighty One, please. He would not do this, he must have been framed. Jail us and beat us, we should be blamed.
not he. How you can accuse me is a mystery. Save him, take me. Benjamin is straighter than the tall palm tree. I hear the steel drums sing their song. They're singing, man, you know you got it wrong. I hear the voice of the yellow bird singing in the trees, this is quite absurd. Oh yes,
oh yes,
it's true,
it's true.
Benjamin is straighter than the big bamboo. No ifs,
no ifs,
no buts,
no buts.
Benjamin is honest as coconuts. Sure as the tide washed the golden sand, Benjamin is an innocent man. Sure as banana need the sun, we are the criminal guilty ones. Oh no,
oh no,
not he,
not he. All you can accuse him is a mystery.
Save him,
take me,
take me.
Benjamin is straighter than the tall palm tree.
Sure as banana need the sun, we are the criminal guilty ones. Oh no,
oh no,
not he,
not he.
All you can accuse him is a mystery.
Save him,
take me,
take me.
Benjamin is straighter than the tall palm tree.
Is it hard to see that Joseph, who you thought was dead, your brother, is me?
I closed my eyes.
I was left alone.